Firefly Aerospace, a US-based launch provider known for its Alpha rocket, has announced its new MLV, or medium launch vehicle, named Eclipse. This announcement comes with an investment of $50 million from Northrop Grumann, a major aerospace firm partnering with Firefly on the MLV's development. Northrop Grumann provides cargo services to the International Space Station, but needs to switch from Russian-sourced engines to American-made alternatives, prompting its partnership with Firefly. Jason Kim, CEO of Firefly Aerospace, stated that the 16 metric ton to orbit capability means Eclipse is in a sweet spot for supporting a wide range of missions. In addition to national security payloads and cargo missions to space stations, it can send landers to the moon or scientific instruments to deep space. The National Security Space Launch, or NSSL for short, is a program managed by the US Space Force to ensure reliable, secure, and cost-effective access to space for national security missions. These kind of missions pay well, as they carry critical military satellites for the US government. And with Golden Dome around the corner, the US will need to launch hundreds, if not thousands, of satellites in the coming years. Currently, SpaceX and United Launch Alliance serve as NSSL providers, with Rocket Lab and Stoke Space on-ramped recently. However, ULA's Vulcan Centaur has only launched twice, with just 14 Atlas V rockets remaining, all allocated to existing missions. The limited flight history for Vulcan Centaur creates an opportunity for Firefly's Eclipse medium launch vehicle to compete for national security contracts, pending a certification by the US Space Force. Given the falling out between President Trump and SpaceX's CEO Elon Musk, with Musk at one point threatening to decommission the Dragon spacecraft, the United States' sole means of sending astronauts to space, the US government is scrambling to find alternative providers. According to a Wall Street Journal report, US government officials have contacted Blue Origin, Stoke Space, and Rocket Lab to assess the readiness of their rockets for government missions. This outreach reflects growing urgency to secure alternatives to SpaceX amid ongoing tensions. Sierra Space, the developers of the Dream Chaser space plane, met with NASA as the Trump-Musk feud continued. Fatih Osman, Sierra Space's CEO, told the Washington Post, "Sierra Space stands ready to ensure uninterrupted support for the International Space Station. NASA mentioned to us that they want diversity and do not want to rely on a single provider. Dream Chaser is in final testing and integration at Kennedy Space Center. We are working closely with NASA leadership to fly this vehicle later this year," unquote. If Firefly can get their Eclipse vehicle ready soon, it could capture launch contracts from competitors, particularly SpaceX, given the urgency to find alternatives to SpaceX for launching critical assets into space. Eclipse will launch from Virginia's Mid-Atlantic Regional Spaceport, the same facility used by Rocket Lab's Neutron rocket. Capable of lifting 16 metric tons to low Earth orbit, Eclipse supports missions to the International Space Station, future commercial space stations, national security payloads, and lunar or deep space exploration. Eclipse integrates flight-proven avionics from Northrop Grumman's Antares program, enhanced with modern upgrades, and features a spacious 5.4-meter, that's 17-foot, payload fairing to accommodate large or multiple satellites. Firefly anticipates the first launch of Eclipse in 2026. Designed for reusability, Eclipse features return-to-launch site capability, with its first stage performing propulsive landings to reduce costs and increase launch frequency. Eclipse manufacturing and testing is well underway. Okay, let's look at the technology in the new vehicle. Technology. The key piece of technology for Eclipse is the upgraded engines. The Miranda engines, currently undergoing an extensive test campaign, have completed over 60 hot fire tests, demonstrating reliability and performance. Scaled up from the flight-proven Reaver engine used in Firefly's Alpha rocket, the Miranda engines power Eclipse's ability to deliver 16 metric tons to low Earth orbit. In addition to the engines, the carbon composite structures provide high strength while reducing the mass of the vehicle, resulting in heavier payloads delivered to space. It helps that Firefly's manufacturing and testing facilities are co-located at the Texas Rocket Range, as this streamlines the design, development, testing, and manufacturing of Eclipse. Okay, let's look at the vehicle now. The vehicle is 59 meters in length with a fairing diameter of 5.4 meters. The first stage uses 7 Miranda engines for a total thrust of 7,161 kilonewtons. The second stage uses 1 Vira engine, producing 890 kilonewtons of thrust. The engine runs on RP-1 fuel and liquid oxygen propellant. In terms of performance, Eclipse can lift 16,300 kilos of mass to low Earth orbit, 3,200 kilos to geotransfer orbit, and 2,300 kilos to translunar injection. That is, it can send 2,300 kilos towards the Moon. Will Firefly pivot to Eclipse and stop launching their smaller Alpha rocket? Other companies, including SpaceX and Relativity Space, have pivoted from small vehicles to medium launch vehicles in the past. Could Firefly now do the same? The rationale is that it's very difficult to make any money in the small launcher market, as Rocket Lab dominates this space. Their Electron vehicle has a high success rate at around 95%, with relationships across all customers looking to launch smaller satellites. Combine that with SpaceX providing regular rideshare missions with Transporter and the new bandwagon flights, and it's hard to see how Firefly can make any money without moving to larger and more lucrative payloads. In contrast, Eclipse, with its 16,300 kilo capacity to low Earth orbit, positions Firefly to compete for high-value satellite constellation missions, an opportunity Rocket Lab is also targeting with its Neutron rocket. Add to that national security missions from the US government, such as launching GPS satellites, offer lucrative contracts. These payloads, too heavy for small rockets like Alpha, are well within Eclipse's capabilities. The upcoming Golden Dome initiative, involving several satellite constellations for communications, imaging, tracking, and kinetic effect satellites for the US Space Force, further proves the demand for medium-lift vehicles. Pivoting to building Eclipse appears to be a sensible move, as the market is less crowded, with a higher margin and plenty of business. Upcoming events. The first flight of the Firefly Eclipse vehicle is expected sometime in 2026. We'll keep you informed on this exciting new rocket from Firefly and wish them the best as their testing phase nears completion. Do you think Firefly Eclipse will be able to compete with existing and upcoming medium launch vehicles? Leave your thoughts in the comments section below. Thanks for watching. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. I recap the videos I posted this week, answer questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Be sure to like and subscribe so you will see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.